There is a certain distrustful attitude to bank crooks. People don't understand how they consider payments, all that interest on interest, and as a result, you overpay twice as much, cursing that you got involved in this endless servitude. In my opinion, basic financial literacy should be taught in school, because finances concern absolutely everyone, but most of us don't even think about it. I don't quite understand why only economists are familiar with this topic. After all, people of almost all professions take loans, but only a few have a clear understanding of this venture. I suggest we finish justifying this important topic and go on to the illustrative examples. You live in a consumer society, in a world where material attributes emphasize your status and significance, so God forbid if you don't have a trendy car yet. Well, let's say you need $10,000 more, and you decide to take a loan for this amount for a period of 1 year at 50%. The interest is, of course, fantastic and more suitable for microfinance organizations, but I deliberately exaggerate to get the point across. So, here you are trying to figure out what's what, and by simple calculations it turns out that by taking $10,000 today, in a year you will have to pay off $15,000, right? 50% is $5,000, that's interest on the loan, and you will still need to return the original amount, the principal of the loan, in the amount of $10,000. But actually, it's not like that. The correct answer is that we will have to pay off $12,708. And that's not all, there is one more correct answer. We will return $12,910. Yes, there are two options. Why is this so? When giving you a loan, banks always take the risk. You might suddenly decide to leave for an indefinite period, or having yelled screw society, just forget about the debt, or God forbid, you become like me. Therefore, banks oblige the borrower to pay off the loan every month. In other words, you are paying not for 1 year with a 50% rate, but rather 12 months with an interest rate of 4.17%. That is, every month you pay off some amount, and having paid off after the first month, you reduce the balance of payment. So, in the second month, the payment amount should also decrease. And here we move to the question of who calculates it that way. After all, the result depends on the selected payment system. In general, there are two. The first one is called differentiated. Its essence is that every month we pay off a different amount, which is gradually decreasing. If we look at our specific example, then in the first month we will pay $1,250, in the second, $1,215, in the third, $1,181, and so on, until the last 12th month, where the final payment will be $868. To understand why this happens, we need to see what the payment consists of. Yes, the amount seems to be $1,250, but what is the principal of the loan in this, i.e., a part of borrowed funds, real money that we were given, mathematically divided by the number of months, and what is interest here, i.e., bank fee, for the service of issuing a loan? Under this system, there is one static, unchangeable part in the payments, the principal of the loan. It is obtained by a simple mathematical division of 10,000 divided by 12 months. It means that we will have to pay $833 in any case, giving back the borrowed money to the bank. But the principle of interest payments is more exotic here. It is constantly changing. The thing is that this percentage is calculated from the loan balance, i.e., in the first month, when we still had not paid off anything and we owe $10,000, then we take a monthly rate of 4.17%, multiply it by 10,000, and get $417. So, for the first month, we pay back $833, the principal of the loan. We return the bank its money. Plus 417 is the fee for the loan issuing service. The next month, this operation is repeated, but the remaining $10,000 has decreased by $833 since we have already returned it. Thus, 4.17% is calculated from $9,167, and it turns out $382. At the same time, do not forget that the principal of the loan remains unchanged. So, in the second month, we have to pay $833 plus $382, and that is $1,215. Similarly, we proceed further until completely paying off the loan. In words, it may seem confusing, so we better look at the visual representation of this whole thing. It turns out that our first payments are always more expensive than the last. That's why this type of payments is called loans for the well-off people, or for those who know their stuff. Because the ordinary citizen is not interested in all this, and it may even think they are being deceived by different sums varying from month to month. And, in general, banks are evil, capitalists are bastards. Therefore, most often people choose the second type. This is despite the fact that in the end, it is somewhat more expensive. The second system is the most popular and profitable for banking crooks. A fancy name was also given to it, the annuity type of payments. Its essence is that every month the payments are the same. It is because of their comprehensibility and permanence that they took root in the people. In our example, the monthly payment will be $1,076, and that's all, no changes. The difference here can be illustrated with weights. At first, there is a very small part of the credit in the payment. In other words, we practically pay off only interest, and then with each month, the ratio changes. Compare it to the differentiated payments where the principal of the loan was fixed. That is, in the first, second, and third month, we paid back $833. Now compare it with the annuity type, where in the first, second, and third month, we pay back $659, $687, and $715, respectively. At the same time, we remember that the total payment is $1,076, and that means the rest is just a service charge. And look what the trick is. Suppose you decide to repay a loan early, let's say after the fourth month. To understand how much you need to pay, we add up payments for these 4 months. Moreover, please note these are not the total payments, but only the principal of the loan. By annuity, we paid $2,806, and by differentiated, $3,333. That's how much interest we paid when using equal payments, and this much when using a constantly decreasing system. That is, in 4 months, we find ourselves paying off the debt more quickly in a differentiated manner, and accordingly, we need to pay back off. In an annuity, we mainly paid interest, i.e. not borrowed funds, but rather fees for the loan service. Moreover, we even paid a little extra. And if we compare the full payment for these two types, it turns out that with a differentiated system, we will pay $12,708, and with an annuity, $12,910. And you might want to say, to hell with banks imposing annuity payments, but not everyone has the opportunity to pay more. And that's what happens with differentiated payments, and the payments become equal only after the sixth month. But this is all in theory. The differences are small here, $200 plus, and the interest rate is unrealistically inflated. Well, let's get back to earth. First, we will come up with a reasonable interest rate. For example, 9%. It seems to be a real value. And let's imagine that our plans are much more global, and we are going to buy an apartment we will take a $2 million mortgage for. I'm afraid they'll not give us a loan for a year, and we won't be able to pay it off. Well, let's take it for at least 20 years. It turns out we will need to pay to the bank 240 times, and we will have to make the initial payment in the amount of a measly $300,000. And here, the difference becomes more significant. The cost of the total overpayment here is $1,536,375 and $1,970,882, respectively. And besides, I ask you to note that these values are strictly overpayments. That is, we returned $2 million that the bank gave us and added these extras on top as service payments. On the one hand, the benefits seem obvious, $500,000. Let's switch to the differentiated type. But on the other hand, we will pay more, $19,833 per month against $15,295 when using the annuity. The difference of roughly $5,000 per month can be a significant burden. Therefore, in reality, it may be really worth listening to bank crooks. Moreover, when considering the first option, we will equalize the payment only. Pay attention. Earlier, we looked at an example of 6 months and it didn't feel like that much. But here, after 87 months, we will pay $15,265. Yes, it will get easier after the 88th month and so on until the 240th, but in these first 87 months, we should try not to die. Now you know how loans really work, and you will know this business if the bank offers you a choice between differential payments and annuity. And who knows, maybe in the future, this episode will help you save $500,000. Or you decide not to get involved in this bank servitude altogether. Any option is acceptable. The main thing is that you know the tricks of interest accrual. Did you like this episode? Smash that like and subscribe to the channel. That's it for today, and I'm Bony Wright.